Okay, so to make this donut-shaped beanbag or cushion, you will need the following items: brown material, this is going to be for the donut itself. I have pink material here, but if you want to use a different color for the icing, you can. And also, I chose a shiny material so that it makes it look like that glossy icing. Then you will need a ruler or a tape measure, some scissors, and some thread that will match the two colors that you've chosen for your cloth. Also, I didn't show it on here, but you will need a sewing machine and some pins and some chalk. If you want to make a cushion, you can stick the material together with a hot glue gun. But because I'm making a bean bag, I'm going to use a sewing machine. So the first thing I'm going to do is to turn my rectangle piece of material into a square. So what I've done here is I've folded the square in half and then again in half, so it makes a smaller square. Okay, so this is the tricky part because you don't want to cut along the wrong edge. So what you want to do is you want to make sure that the sides where the material is folded is closer to you, because you're going to be cutting from one folded edge to the other folded edge. You don't want to be cutting along the line where it's single material. Okay, so now you need to have a rough idea of how big you want your cushion or your beanbag to be. But here's where the dreaded math comes into place. In order for you to cut a perfect circle, this is a trick that I always do. So here I'm measuring out 50 centimeters because I want my beanbag to be 100 centimeters from one edge to the other edge. That's the diameter. So from one side of the circle to the other side of the circle, that's the diameter. And mine is gonna be 100 centimeters. So now I'm gonna be cutting around 50 centimeters. So what I'm doing is I'm taking my ruler from the point of the square, and I'm measuring 50 centimeters outwards in different angles. And once I've made all my markings on my material, I'm gonna draw around to connect those dots together. Okay, so the same rule applies for cutting out the middle circle of the donut. Now I measured out 15 centimeters. Now that's going to give me a diameter of 30 centimeters. So the middle circle of my donut is going to measure 30 centimeters from one edge to the other. Now all you need to do is cut it out. You will need two of these brown pieces of material exactly the same. So you can either put the two materials together and do the whole process together, or you can do them separately. So for the icing, I'm just gonna turn my pink material the wrong side up so I can draw on the back of the material. I'm gonna lay my brown material on the top and I'm gonna trace around the edges. Now what I'm doing is I'm going to draw uneven sides because I want the icing to look uneven. I don't want it to be a perfect icing on the top. I want it to be like it's been dripping around the sides and stuff. Okay, so what I'm doing here, I'm laying on top the pink material on top of the brown material, and I'm gonna do this right side up. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stitch the pink to the brown so that it doesn't move around. Now comes the sewing part. If you're comfortable using a sewing machine, you can follow the way that I'm doing it. If you're making a cushion and you're going to use cushion stuffing, you can use the hot glue gun, but I prefer to use a sewing machine. Okay, so now what I'm doing, I'm gonna lay on top of that, I'm gonna lay the other piece of brown material. And I'm gonna lay this on top wrong side up. So if you've got any markings on your material, you want those markings to be on the top, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna flip it inside out afterwards. Now it's really important that you do not sew the whole circle. If you do that, then you won't be able to put your stuffing on the inside. So sew around the circle, but then leave a gap of maybe 15 centimeters or maybe 20 centimeters, depending on how big your cushion or your beanbag is gonna be. Leave a big enough gap so that you can put the stuffing on the inside. Now turn the whole thing inside out. Well, I say inside out, but it's going to be the right way around now. Now once you've laid it all out, pin it together, and now you're going to sew the inner circle. Now get your filler ready. So I'm using these beanbag balls, but you can use cushion stuffing if you want to. Now once I've filled my beanbag, I'm gonna sew it up by hand. And it's nearly complete. So as you can see, it's starting to come together. Now to finish off, I just painted on some sprinkles. You can use any other colors that you want, depending on what color icing you have. So that is it. That is exactly how to make a beanbag that looks like a donut or a cushion. And I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it wasn't too hard, but for now, thank you so much for watching. And if you like it, don't forget to subscribe.